If you ever open a HTML file, we will notice that it's filled with angle brackets. This is actually IAM web page HTML file. So the angle bracket is basically consists of a smaller than and greater than sign, okay? And the angle bracket is called tag in HTML. The tag came in a pair, so you have an open tag and a closing tag, okay? The closing tag have a slash in between the two greater than equal brackets. So in between the bracket is what we call the element of the HTML. So in this case is H1, which stands for heading 1. So the H1 content had to appear on the opening bracket, which is opening tag, and the closing tag, like this. Now in between the opening and closing tag is the content. Okay, in this case is hello world. So let's see how it looks like on the browser. So I will save this file. You can press Ctrl S to save the file, and you need to go to the browser and press the refresh button. As you can see, this is called hello world. There are total 6 levels of this heading. So let me demonstrate what it looks like. Okay, so if I save the file, if I refresh, this is what you get. So the higher the level, the smaller the font it will be. Let's summarize what we have learned from the tag or angle brackets. The HTML tag generally comes in pair. There is an open tag and a closing tag. I say generally is because there are some exceptions. Element tags such as meta, link, image, break and horizontal line do not need a closing tag. The name of the HTML element will appear in between the opening tag. In this case, it is a header level 1 element tag or H1 element tag. The content of the element tag will appear in between the opening and closing tag of the element. In this case, hello ICTSIG is the content of the element H1. There is one additional thing that you will need to know about the element tag, and that is the attribute to the element. This is a link element with a relationship or real attribute which is set to stylesheet, and a hypertext reference or href equal to styles.css, which is a stylesheet file. You don't have to worry about what are these attributes means at this moment, as I will cover them more in details in the coming lessons. Another example is a horizontal line tag with an attribute of color, which is set to red. And this is obvious, as you would have figured out that the color of the horizontal line is set to red.